If you go over there and take my master class, it will get you up to speed on what I'm doing with this real money trading series, growing a small account in the futures market and with swing trading. And I chose the futures market to go with this because I don't have to worry about the PDT rule and I can day trade. In my master class, I take you from day one, I want to be a trader, then selecting a broker, opening an account, then teaching you how I build winning strategies that fit you. So I call it the PLG, personality, lifestyle, and goals. But not just that, strategies that have a proven statistical probability of success. Once we build our strategies, then we build a trade plan to go with those strategies. Two completely different things, traders. You need a good strategy and a good trade plan to be successful. Then I sim trade those strategies, and now we're into the real money trading portion of building a winning strategy. That is what this series is about. I plan on trading these accounts until the end of 2023, and we'll see how far we can grow them in 1 year's time. Now, I don't know if these strategies are going to be successful. We're going to find this out together. And if they're not, hopefully I can tweak them along the way to make them successful. I started my futures account with $1,700 because that was the bare minimum I felt like I could start with. And then I started my swing trading account with $2,000. Again, I felt that was the bare minimum I can start with. In my masterclass, I explain all these details on why I make the decisions, what you're seeing on the screens, the charts that you're seeing, all the tools, all that stuff. This class can benefit beginner traders and pro traders alike. I do trade with my algorithm, but you don't need that in order to benefit from my masterclass. You can trade with whatever tool it is for you. If you're thinking about taking somebody else's class, my masterclass can help you choose what other strategy might be right for you. This way, if you're gonna spend a lot of money to buy somebody else's strategy, it would really be good if that strategy would fit you. And I teach you all about that in my masterclass, so go check it out. But for now, let's get into today's video. All right, so here we are. We have a red light, green light trade setting up. We've had quite a few winners in red light, green light. This will make it five or six if this trade is successful. But we do have a trade had set up for red light, green light and 30 minute candle in the futures market with the MES. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump in. I just came to the computer and saw this. So we got a little red candle developing. The question is it gonna keep going down or not? So right now, I mean, we're looking at, you know, potential for it to keep going up. But see, when I move this up and down the ladder, you could see on the monitor, on the chart, my line moving up and down. So this is a long trade. So now that we've gone red, we went from green to red. I'm gonna go ahead and put my entry in right here. So yes, I'll be getting in a little bit late. So I'll be risking a little more than I'll be making in reward, actually quite a bit more, because I'm gonna move my stop to just below here and make a new low. But I wanted to give it a chance to start to sell off. But if it does boost from here, I wanna be in this trade, even though I'm a little bit off on my risk reward, it's still worth it for me to get in, and I can make it back on this side. So one thing that I have going for me on this trade, let me show you the 4 hour. So now we're going green, right? I probably could have just bought in right there, but you know, it's a dollar. So $5 basically is what I'm giving up to wait and see if it wants to sell off. And then if I can get in down here, that's even better, right? Because there's a good chance it could come back down, retest this support area before boosting, but we'll see what's gonna happen here. We might get in the trade, maybe not. It was green, then it went red, now it's back green, so it might continue in the green direction. We're halfway through this 30 minute candle, so anything can happen. All right, well, let's go over the 4 hour chart. Okay, so here we are on the 4 hour chart. You can see this massive tower candle that's in play right here. So there's a really high probability that this is going to retrace a little bit before continuing lower. We haven't really seen much retracement whatsoever. Our target is a retracement basically of almost half of this, less than half of this. So it makes it even higher probability that this red light, green light, even though we've had a lot of winners, will be another one of those winners, because there's a good chance for retracement. Sometimes it doesn't, right here, boom, right? Flag over and down. This could flag over and down, but this had a draw to it. There's a support level here, had a big tower candle to retrace. There was a bunch of stuff drawing this thing down here. So right here, you could see my, here, I'll just draw, I use this one, close enough. So this area, it's not an exact number, not an exact line. You know, I could say it's here. This area is a support area. This whole area is a support area. And right now we're coming into that support area. And typically when you get into a support area, there's some kind of rebound away from it. Even if it's a little rebound away and then it goes down. Other times it'll just gap right past it and, you know, and crash basically, gap and crash. And sometimes it will boost just right through with these big candles and it'll be like, whoa, just destroyed that support area. But a lot of times, more times than not, you'll have some reaction. Maybe not a big reaction, but some reaction. But we don't need a big reaction for this trade to be successful. We just need a small reaction. So I'm just leave those on right now. We'll go back to the 30-minute chart. Okay, so now we're going red again. So I left those lines in. You can kind of see this is the support area that we're in. I'm going to move my stop just below this, probably at the bottom of the support area. If it gets down there and I get stopped out, then it rallies. All good. But the rules are I can move my stop to below this. I don't have to put it here. As long as it's within 25% of the move, then we can do it. All right, so now we're going red again. So this may come down here for a bit, which would be awesome. If this will come all the way back down here and we can get in really close to risk, that would be fantastic. So we'll just kind of keep an eye on this. I'll let this order stay open. I'll let this keep recording. We'll keep an eye on it and see if we end up jumping in. All right, so now we're in a telling spot right here. Will we break above this red candle or below this red candle? A close above, chances are we're going higher, at least for a while. Maybe we don't get our target, but chances are we are definitely going up. If we have a break below this red candle, chances are we're going down. Why? Because we have a red candle here that closed below this green candle. Will it confirm a reverse in trend or direction by having another red candle close below it? Or is it going to just be a retrace before it move higher? So a lot of times you see you had a red candle close below, then as soon as you have another one closing below it or below at least the next green candle over, that you start to get that trend downward. It's not really something I can trade off of as a strategy because there's not a solid entry exit that gives me equal winning to losing or credit to debit. I don't want to be in a trade where I'm risking, you know, $100 this trade to make $100 and the next trade I'm risking $1,000 to make $100. I don't like that volatility in your risk reward and what you're making. I want to be able to say each trade I want to risk around $100, give or take a little bit, but it's not going to be like make $100 today, risk $100 today, tomorrow risk $1,000. So I don't want that. And by having something solid to trade against, it gives me that. Now, could I come up with a strategy that uses those candles to do that? Maybe. I've actually looked at it. It's quite difficult. So I stuck with what works great for me. But a lot of times, once the candle closes below the other candle or above, we start, and then you have that follow through, you start to see a little bit of a trend or a consolidation period that begins. So we'll have to see. We'll see what happens right here. All right, so we're back with that trade. We finally did it. We took a loser, or we just got a debit, right? We did our debit. So all good. Been waiting for one of these. We haven't had one since October when we're playing with, as long as we're not casino trading, we haven't had one. We did have that one that was a casino trade. We had a perfect record until today. And now we got our debit finally. We finally have to pay to play a little bit. So here was the trade. I told you this lines were going to be the zone of resistance or support rather. So it came down. It did hit that. It rebounded and went into our target. I put my stop just below here, and I told you I should put my stop below this resistance area, well below it, but then that risk-reward ratio is way too off, and the probabilities of the system is based on getting stopped out here, so all good to be stopped out here. I did want to give myself a little extra so that I would have at least an opportunity of this this low here. Unfortunately, we got through that low, took that loss, and then it rebounded and hit the target. So that part is kind of frustrating, but all good. And then we'll just have to see what happens. You know, there was a setup here that we didn't take at 5 a.m, of course. That was winner. And then we'll see what the next setup brings, and hopefully we can have one come up soon and recover what we just gave away. Okay, here we are on the My Strategy Manager. So this is the trade that we were just in. Long, ended up taking a loser. 29.75 is what we ended up losing on it, which is actually not too bad. We were risking 30.25, so somehow we got out a little bit less. But either way, took a loss, all good. That does set us back a little bit. We come over to the scaling ladder. You can see we lost a bar. So this automatically will turn green and go away as my account is developing. So I don't have to do anything here. Just come over and look at it and see where I'm at and see what zone I can trade in, what's my risk reward, all that stuff. It automatically fills in for me based on what's going on with my account. So it's pretty awesome. So it took a bar away. So we'll have to wait and see what happens. Maybe we can get that back later today or tomorrow. All right, everybody. So that's going to do it for today. And we'll bring you the next trade to you. All right, so here we are with red light, green light setting up again. Yes, it's like 3 o'clock in the morning, but or about to be 3 o'clock in the morning. And I know some of you are watching this video saying, I wouldn't be trading at 3 o'clock in the morning. Well, it depends on where you're at. You know, if you're in Japan on vacation and you wanna trade like at, you know, normal hours where you're not up all night and trying to be on vacation, you might be trading at 3 o'clock in the morning, New York Stock Exchange time. So anyway, here we are. We're getting ready to jump in about 50 seconds with red light, green light. We have full permission on the trade. We're just coming off of that loser, which was unfortunate, but you know, good at the same time because we need to have them, or that debit, if you will, right? We debited from the account. But here's the thing, like, you see this consolidation that's right here? I mean, am I buying this near the middle or top of the channel just for it to come all the way back down and then become a failed trade and have another debit? Or is this going to break out and then retest this area up here? And then in that case, I have a credit to my account. I can sit there and look at that from a subjective viewpoint, look for confirmation bias, all the different stuff. Okay, we're going to jump in here in 3, 2, 1. Let's jump in just a skosh. Make sure we get in on the candle close. What? Okay. That was weird. So I got a rejection and then it bought it. Strange. Anyway, so we're in. So I could look at this from a subjective viewpoint and confirmation bias and all that and convince myself to go one way or the other. Or I can just trade on a statistical proven probability of success and play the numbers game. And that is what I intend to do. So I'm going to mark it up right here. So that's a small move. We're just looking for the top of this channel, actually, for our target. So pretty sweet. And then this is the stop right here, looking to break down below this towards the bottom of the channel. I could play the bottom of this here, but you can see that that's a significant difference for my risk. I'm just going to put my my target in as it is. So OCO order right here. And then let's bump this up to like 50. I'm going to open this up a little bit right here. As soon as I see the arrows, I can left click and drag it. Auto to reset this chart to the normal view. And then, all right, so I gotta do this again. Okay, OCO, 50, enter. Always have to hit enter up there. You'll just see the number, but it won't actually be what you're getting ready to do. And then I bought it to go long, so now I gotta sell it. So I'm gonna sell it, put my number there, drag this up to my target, all right there. I'll put it just a skosh under, because I'm gonna go to bed. And if it gets 90% of the way, I'm not going to be able to move my stop to break even, which is part of the rules. And then I'm going to miss out, actually. So I'm just going to do that. I'll put this at the 90% level, and then I'll be good to go. And then down here, make it break it on that. So we'll go ahead and put this in the My Strategy Manager, see what those numbers look like. And then, you know, hopefully we'll have a credit instead of a debit, but whatever. We've had a lot of credits or a lot of winners, so definitely losers are in store. Even a losing streak is in store. So eventually those will come, but hopefully not right now. So let's go put that in the My Strategy Manager. Okay, and then our stop is 3927.3, which will really end up being like 2.5 probably. So we're looking at 1825 as our risk, 18.25. I always put these in here so that later on when I go back and review my account, I can see that this is what I was risking and this is what I was making, right? And then later on I can kind of see how that all plays out. And then I can look at the charts and be like, should I have made my full risk? Is that possible? Like, and is there ways to fine tune what I'm doing to maximize my profits? So I like to see what my risk is versus my reward. This also helps me use the calculators, custom calculators, to be able to determine contract size, especially later once we can start dealing with multiple contracts. Right now we can only afford one anyway. So it doesn't do as much for a contract position right now, but it does tell me risk. Like if this was $200 and right now, based on our scaling ladder, we're at $100 risk reward area, right? We come over here. We're looking at basically $100 risk reward. We're not in the 200 bracket yet. So if that trade was big enough for a $200 risk, then I probably want to skip it.
So, all right, so that's our thing. I don't like to leave it on the red side, so let's go with 3961.25. On the futures market with the MES, it likes to get out in the quarter, not like on the small little numbers. All right, so anyway, so there's our target. So we're looking at 1575. So I'm risking quite a bit more than I'm making because I've moved my thing down because I'm going to go to bed and I don't have to wake up when I get alerted at 90% move. So anyway, so there we go. So all in, I'll put in here why. So this way I know why my risk was off target. Come back over. All right, so here we are. So we'll see what this thing does. You know, there was some resistance right here that it's breaking out of. We'll see if it wants to come back up and retest this and we'll make some money. All right, everybody, I'll bring the conclusion to you. All right, so here we are. So here, I know I never do this in my videos because when I zoom out and I look at stuff, it becomes really cluttered. Let me put this on here for you. All right, there you go. So you can see where we entered the trade, and then you can see where we had exited the trade right through here. So fantastic. So we got a winner in there. So let's go ahead and we got a credit. We got a credit in there. P&L day, again, doesn't really mean much, but that's probably pretty accurate to what we're at. Because this is the day, not the actual trade, like not what your actual P&L was from your entry and your exit. 396050. So we got out a little bit less than we had wrote in here. So after commission, $70 is what we get to take home. You know, the downside is, you know, this trade right here that I took, red light, green light, it wasn't a casino trade, but it was, you know, risking around $150. I knew that before I was getting into the trade. And I probably should have said, you know what, I'm going to skip this one because my scaling ladder is telling me the $100 range. Don't risk $150. So and I did. So I should not have done that. And if I had done the right thing, I would have skipped that trade. We would still be perfect in our account. And this would be growing nicely. We might be even another bar up. But I didn't. So it is what it is. Here we are. So anyway, so there we go. So $70, another trade in there like that one. And I'll be able to recover that pretty easily. All right, everybody, see you on the next trade. All right, so I just wanted to show you this not a trade setup so that later on we're looking at the chart, you can be like, hey, you never showed us that trade. Did you not take it? So no, I didn't, and I probably should. Here, let's mark it up real quick. I say I probably should because I'm not going to take it, which means it'll probably be a winner. And I believe the market's bearish right now, so I believe that this trade is going in bearish, you know, it's going within the direction of the market. Trend, if you will. It's following the trend, I believe. But that's my belief. That's subjective. That's my thoughts, my opinions. And I want to trade on a statistical proven probability of success. And that's it. And play the numbers game. So I'm not taking this trade. As you can see, there's no position in it. And the reason is red light, green light, you know, as I teach over in the masterclass, I track my strategies very carefully. And I try to have an 80% success rate or better. And when a strategy starts to fall down, you know, in the 70% range, I definitely don't want to get below 70% or even at 70%. If you've seen my video, 70% or 60 to 70% win rate, good or bad, I think that'll make your eyeballs pop out of your head if you watch that video. It's here on the channel and it's also over at the site simpleswitch.teachable.com as part of the masterclass. But yeah, definitely check that out if you haven't seen it. Really, I think your eyeballs will pop out of your head. So if I start getting below, you know, the 80% into the 70% range, I really need to reevaluate that strategy and see what is happening, because a lot of times, you know, that's going to trend. I'm still profitable with that trend, but it's hard to be profitable as you get there. So it's really hard to make money in that area. So I need to be able to adjust this the strategies to get back up to that 80% range, or at least as close to it as possible, so I can continue growing the account and feel secure about it. So red light, green light has started dropping down, did start dropping down below that 80% into to the low 70s. So I didn't like that. So I went back through the red light, green light strategy and made some tweaks. So right now, what I'm doing in order to get back towards the 80% range is anytime I'm only looking at setups that have full permission. And if you haven't taken my masterclass, highly recommend it. You'll learn a ton of stuff over there about what I'm doing. And it's not about necessarily trading with my algo. It's about trading with your own thing. Like, how do you build a strategy that fits you, your personality, your lifestyle, and your goals? You know, I like to say trade you, not them. Two traders could have the exact same strategy. One could become a millionaire and the other one could go broke. with the exact same strategy because it didn't fit that person that went broke. It just didn't fit them. So they're gonna lose all their money. And so over at my masterclass, I teach you how to take your personality, your lifestyle, and your goals. What is that? How do you figure that out? And then how to take that information and develop that into successful strategies, or at least give you the best possibility for success that I could give you. So here we are. So full permission, and then I'm only going to take a trade now after there's a losing trade. So when a setup happens on full permission and it's a loser or a failed, or it would be a, you know, I'm not going to say a debit because I didn't trade it. So a failed trade or losing trade on a full permission setup, then I'll take the next trade. So, and that's basically how it's going to go. So whenever there's a loser, I'll follow up with the next trade. There's been a really choppy market. So because of the chop, I need to be able to trade that chop. And as soon as, you know, by evaluating what's happening and watching the trend of your strategy, you can see, man, it's getting really choppy. You know, I make some, I lose some, make some, I lose some. Well, what if you just skip the lose some and just go with the make some? That's the plan anyway. So but you know, you get two losers in a row, so I'll still have losses in there. And we'll keep an eye on it. In a few weeks, I may have to adjust it again. But right now, the plan in this really choppy market is to trade after a loser. And that should keep me back closer to the 80% range. So that's why I'm not taking this trade, no trade. And then we'll wait for that loser to come in, and then we'll look to take the next trade. So there you go. You're up to date. See you on the next video.